Hi, I'm Jesse with Redash. In this video, I'll show you how to go through the onboarding steps when you've created a new account in Redash. When you first log in, you'll see this welcome screen, which asks you to connect a data source, create your first query, create your first dashboard, and invite some team members. I wanted to take this opportunity to show you what each of those steps looks like in practice. So let's get started. So each of these bullet points is also a link, so I can actually click to connect a data source. I've created a Postgres instance over at DigitalOcean, so I'm going to search for the Postgres database connector here. There it is. And DigitalOcean gave me the information I needed to connect, including a host name and a port number. Each data source has kind of different parameters, but I did have to open up the firewall at DigitalOcean to allow Redash to get in. Before I started recording this video, on my Postgres server, I created a new user for the Redash software to use. That user has select-only privileges on just a couple of tables. This is standard operating procedure for Redash because the software isn't designed to do any kind of updates or deletes in your database. It's really best to create a user that only has read access to whatever tables you want to be visualizing. In this case, I called that user Redash and gave it its own password, and the database that we're connecting to is called Zonar. Perfect. Now we'll create that data source, and down at the bottom of this screen, let's test the connection to make sure it works. Looks like it does. So now I'll click the Redash logo at the top of the screen, and we'll get back to our getting started list. You'll notice that connecting a data source has been struck through on the list, so yay, one step down. Next, we'll click this link to create our first query. We could also do this by using the Create menu at the top. Alrighty, so this is the query screen, and I need to write myself a query to get some monthly sales data. So I'm going to call this query sales by month. And then over here on the left in the schema viewer, I'll expand out the schema for the two tables that I've given Redash access to. Redash can only see the transactions and users tables. So for this query, I'm going to write a monthly summary of the total purchase price of transactions. As I write this out, I am not doing anything to format the query because I'm going to let Redash do that for me by clicking this Format Query button beneath the query editor. After I do that, I can see it looks like I missed a column alias here. All right, and then we'll go ahead and execute this. Perfect. The one thing I'm missing is I kind of want this data to be sorted in chronological order, so I'll go ahead and add that there. And there, now we have the month and the total sell of transactions. One thing I'll note here is that the query has been written in standard Postgres syntax. There's nothing about using Redash that requires you to learn a new syntax. You just write in the query editor whatever is required by your database engine. You can also hit execute as many times as you need as you work through different versions of the query until you have the data that you want to either visualize or display on a dashboard. But since this query looks how I need it to, we'll go ahead and save it here, and then I'll create a new visualization. This will just be a bar chart showing the total sales by month. We'll make it green, update the axis to look nicer. And perfect, we'll publish that. And then we'll click the Redash logo at the top of the screen and get back to the getting started area. Now you can see that create your first query has been struck through, so we're almost done. Finally, let's go ahead and create our first dashboard by clicking this link. I'll call this one sales metrics. And as soon as I save it, I'll be jumped to the dashboard editor where I can add the chart that I just created onto this dashboard. Now, this is a really simple example of a dashboard, but if I wanted to share this with other people, I can publish it and then click this share widget. I could generate a secret address and then send this to coworkers or colleagues. But really, the best option is to create more Redash users, which I can do from the getting started screen. I just have to provide a name and an email address. And once they've created an account, they'll be able to see any dashboard that I share with them. You also don't have to use the getting started links to connect data sources or create queries or dashboards or invite people. You can click this settings widget up here on the upper right. When you do, there's a tab for all kinds of settings for your Redash instance. Here's where you could add another data source or a tab where you can add more users. Also, you should probably know how to create favorites, which you can do by clicking the gold star beside any dashboard title or query title. The gold stars are visible from the list views or from the dashboard editor or the query editor. Anytime you see that gold star filled in, that means this is one of your favorites. Your favorites are going to be visible from the starting screen in Redash, and they also appear in the little dropdowns off the menu. And that's how you complete the onboarding in your Redash account. Thank you so much for watching.